Hey Andrew, so I just wanted to walk you through this other problem because it's somewhat similar to the ones that we did before, but this time we have a 90-degree angle, which is going to make this tremendously helpful because then we don't need to use law of sines or law of cosines. We can just use regular sine and cosine. So we don't need to worry about all of that. We just need to set this up, and so this is our angle. And so we need to figure out what all of these other sides are. So this one should, the longest side and the side opposite of the 90-degree angle should always be the hypotenuse. And then the side that is next to the 20-degree angle is the adjacent side. So that's going to be our adjacent. And then the side opposite of this one will be, well, opposite. So those are our sides now. Now, once we've got that figured out, now all we have to do is set up an equation. So notice that we don't know this side, so we don't want to use opposite. We want to use an equation that has adjacent and that has hypotenuse. So we're going to do SOHCAHTOA and find one that has adjacent and hypotenuse. So which one of those has that? Not sine. Cosine does. So we're going to use CA. So notice that ca is with the c, so c stands for cosine. Remember, s stands for sine, and t stands for tangent. So cosine of, and what has to go inside of a cosine is always the angle. So cosine of 20 degrees, and that has to be equal to the adjacent divided by the hypotenuse. That's what all of these rules are. So these are always this, not this guy divided by that guy. So cosine of our angle equals the adjacent over the hypotenuse, which in this case is x divided by 2. So now we're left with cosine of 20 degrees is equal to x over 2. Now, if you have if you plug it into your calculator, into your scientific calculator, we sh or you can also plug it into Google, but if you plug it into Google, you need to make sure that you type 20 degrees here instead of just 20. So cosine of 20 degrees is about 0.94, and that's equal to x over 2. And then to solve for x, we just need to multiply both sides by 2. And then we should be left with x equals 2 times 0.94, which is approximately 1.88, because we did 2 times 1 point, or times 0.94. Well, I already wrote that up above. So this becomes 1.88, and this is our final answer.